Hello students, welcome all of you to the online digital class. In today's class, I am going to discuss about a new topic which is included in class 10 syllabus. The name of the topic is Festivals of Northeast India. Okay, here I want to say that I have also discussed another new topic from class 10 syllabus, that is at the high school, in my previous video. So you may watch the video by searching Vidyasa classes in YouTube, okay, or you can get the link from the description box. Okay, so let's start our today's class. The name of the topic is Festivals of Northeast India. Okay, India is our homeland, which is situated in South Asia. It is the second most populous country after China. Okay, and it is the seventh largest country by land area. Russia is the largest country by its land area, and India comes in seventh position by its land area. Okay, and we all know that India is a land of fairs and festivals. People from different communities and different religion are living here, and they are celebrating different types of festivals throughout the year. Okay, important festivals are Ganesh Chaturthi, Basant Panchami, Diwali, Dashera, Raksha Bandhan, Eid ul Fitr, Christmas, Buddha Jayanti, Mahavir Jayanti, etc. The people from different religion and celebrating different types of festivals in different regions of our country with a lot of fun and joy. Okay, dear students, now I am going to discuss about the northeastern part of India. Northeastern part of India is a collective name for the easternmost part of India, which is representing both a geographic and administrative division of the country. Okay, and it is comprises of 8 states. The name of 8 states are, you may remember it by applying the formula, that is A square M cube N S T. Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Sikkim and Tripura. Dear students, there is little bit mistake in your book. It is written that it is comprises of 8 states, but instead of 8 states, the list of 7 states are there. Okay, so we may correct it by adding the state Nagaland. Okay, and out of the 8 states, the 7 states are called as contiguous states. So what is the meaning of contiguous? Contiguous means touching or sharing the boundaries of each other. So the 7 states are touching each other and they're sharing their boundaries with each other. So these 7 states are called as contiguous states and also commonly called as or described as land of 7 sisters. So who are the land of 7 sisters? So this name of the 7 states are A square, M cube, N T. Okay, here is also a little bit mistake is there in our book. Instead of 7 states, list of 6 states are there. So we may include it or correct it, but by adding this state Tripura. Okay, and here Sikkim is not considered as a contiguous states because it is not sharing its boundary with the 7 states. And it is separated from the 7 states by the Siliguri corridor, and hence it is not considered as a contiguous states and also not comes under land of 7 sisters. Okay, and hence it is the state Sikkim acts as a little brother of the amazing 7 sisters. Okay, dear students, now I am going to discuss about the festivals of Northeast India, how the people of Northeast India are celebrating different types of festivals with great enthusiasm and joy. Okay, before going to describe about the festivals of Northeast India, I am going to discuss about the 4 points regarding festival, that is which festivals they are celebrating, second one when they celebrate the festival, and third one why they celebrate the festival, and fourth one what the people do in that festival. Okay, so we should remember all the 4 points. Now look at the festivals of Assam. The people of Assam are called as Assamese. And the people are celebrating different type of festivals with great enthusiasm and joy. The important festival that is called Bihu festival, which is organizing by the people or celebrating by the people of Assam. There are three types of Bihu festivals like Rongali Bihu, Kongali Bihu and Bhogali Bihu. Rongali Bihu is also called as Bohag Bihu. When they celebrated in mid-April with the onset of spring. And why they celebrate it? They celebrate it to mark the new year of Assam and the beginning of harvest season. Okay, and what they do? The people wear traditional dresses and dance. Second type of Bihu festival is Kongali Bihu, which is also called as Koti Bihu. And when they celebrate it? They celebrate it in mid-October. And what is the reason why they celebrate it? They celebrate it for a thriving harvest and to guide souls to heaven. And what the people do? The people light lamps, pray to God, sing and dance. And third type of Bihu festival is Bhogali Bihu, which is also called as Magh Bihu. And they celebrate it at the end of the harvest season. Why they celebrate it? They celebrate it to offer thanks to God. And what the people do? The people sing melodious song and dance. Okay, so look at here. And overall, the people wear traditional dresses, sing melodious song and dance. So it is said that Bihu festival is incomplete, or Bihu festival, the celebration of Bihu festival is said to be incomplete without traditional dance and the melodious song. Really, the Bihu dance is joyous one. Yeah. Musical instruments using here or using in Bihu dance are cymbal, bamboo clapper, dhol, drum and pepper. What is pepper? It is a wind instrument which is made from buffalo horns. Okay. Dear students, now I am going to discuss about the festivals of Arunachal Pradesh. The capital of Arunachal Pradesh is Itanagar. Look at the picture. Arunachal Pradesh is one of India's most remote and picturesque locations, with lush green paddy fields and pine-clad mountains. Nature has provided the people of this region with a deep feeling of beauty, which can be seen in their festivities, songs and dances. Here, the important festivals are, first one is Losar. It is an important festival which is organizing by the people of Arunachal Pradesh. And when they celebrate it? They celebrate it at the new year. And why they celebrate it? They celebrate it to mark the start of the new year of Arunachal Pradesh. And what the people do? They clean their home or houses. And for that, they discard their old things from the houses. And here, the young men and women are also, or the people of Arunachal Pradesh are also, sung melodious song and dance. And the second type festival is Mopin festival, which is organizing or celebrating during the harvest. So it is also called as a harvest festival. Here, why they celebrate it? They celebrate it to drive away the evil spirits and for getting prosperity and wealth. What they do? They worship goddess Mopin. And here, the young men and women are dancing a special type of dance, which is called as poppy dance. Okay, or the young men and women are performing the poppy dance here. And the third type of festivals is Zero Musical Festival, which is also called as Iconic Outdoor Musical Festivals. When they celebrate it? They celebrate it in September. And why they celebrate it? They celebrate it for the Congregation of Music and Folk Act. Look at the picture. The music congregation features a combination of 30 indie bands from across the world and top folk acts from across the Northeast India. And here, they also perform different types of folk dance. The second type of festivals is celebrating by the Galo tribe of Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. Dear students, now I am going to discuss about the festivals of Manipur. The capital of Manipur is Imphal. The important festivals are, first one is the Ningal Chakawa. Ningal Chakawa is a charming festival which is celebrating by the people of Manipur. The meaning of Ningle. The word Ningle means married or unmarried daughters, and Chokova means invitation for the lunch to mother's house. Okay, so it is a charming festival which is celebrating by the people of Manipur in the month of October and November. And why they celebrate it? To revive the relationship between married girl and their parents. Okay, what the people do? They give sumptuous food or they sumptuous feast and gift. And the second type of festivals is Chairova. It is a Manipur New Year festival which is celebrating by the people of Manipur in April to mark the start of the new year. And here the people clean and decorate their houses, they prepare special dishes, and also the village people went to the hillside and they climbed the hilltop. Look at the picture. Because they have believed that, this will help them rise to a higher plane in this life. Okay. Dear students, now I am going to discuss about the festivals of Meghalaya and Mizoram. The capital of Meghalaya is Shillong and the capital of Mizoram is Aizawl. Look at the important festivals. The Wangla or 100 Drum Festivals, which is celebrating by the people of Meghalaya in the month of November to mark the end of hard work, because at the time they get the good harvest. And here the people, both men and women, dance in parallel lines and the men are beating the drums and they make a lot of fun and joy. Look at the picture. The celebration features beating of drums, blowing horns, and traditional dancing. The dance during the festival has two parallel lines, one of men and the other of women, clad in their festive costumes. While the men beat the drums, the lines move forward together in a rhythmic manner. And the Chapcharkot festival, which is celebrating by the people of Mizoram, it is celebrating in spring, so it is also called as the spring festival. And as they all finish their work, so they celebrate it for merrymaking. And here all the people are wear their traditional dresses and sing different types of traditional songs and perform the folk dances. They create a festive atmosphere by using the magical instruments like cymbals, gongs, and drums. And all the men and women wear traditional dresses, sing different types of traditional songs, and they dance the folk dances. Okay. Dear students, now I am going to discuss about the festivals of Nagaland. Okay. You all know that the capital of Nagaland is Kohima. Now look at the festivals. The important festivals which is celebrating by the people of Nagaland are, first one is Mostu, which is also called as a colorful festival. And here the people celebrate these festivals after sowing the season, after sowing season, and they celebrate it to preserve the oral history. And here the people are wearing colorful dresses and the headgear, and also they perform different types of dances. Okay, and the second type of, or the second important festivals of the people Nagaland is Hornbill. The Hornbill festival is also called as a colorful and a charming festival, which is celebrating in the month of December. Here the people celebrate the festivals to showcase the cultural heritage, and the people here perform different types of dances and their sporting events, and also the hunting and wearing skills. In Mostu festival, the people are dressed in colorful clothes and headgear decorated with feathers and wild boar tusks. The people in villages dance to the traditional music. Hornbill festival is a 10-day long cultural dance and sporting events held in December every year. Men clad in full warrior costume show off their hunting and warring skills. Dear students, now I am going to discuss about the festivals of Sikkim and Tripura. You all know that the capital of Sikkim is Gangtok and the capital of Tripura is Agartala. The important festivals are Saga Dawa festival. It is a Buddhist festival which is celebrating by the people of Sikkim on full moon day in Tibetan lunar month. They celebrate it to commemorate the birth, enlightenment, and death of Lord Buddha. In here, the people where visit monasteries, they offer prayers, water, incense stick and water lamps. Okay. And the next festival is Losang festivals. It is also an important festival of Assam. Here, the people are celebrating the festival at the end of the harvest season. And they celebrate it for the remembrance of agriculture. Here the people wear brightly colorful masks in their face and they perform a special dance called as charm dance. Here also the people are organizing the archery contest. The Losang festival is celebrated at the end of the harvest season. Locals wearing brightly colored masks, playing fascinating musical instruments, perform charm dance. An archery contest is also held along with feasting and other celebrations. Next, Karachi Puja is also an important festival which is celebrated by the people of Tripura in the month of July, and they celebrate it to mark the animal sacrifice, and for that they worship 14 gods and also they perform different types of cultural programs. Okay. Karachi Puja of Tripura is a week-long festival marked by animal sacrifice and worshipping 14 gods as instructed by Lord Shiva. The festival takes place in the month of July in Old Agartala or Puran Haveli, where there is a temple that houses of 14 deities. Thousands of people throng Tripura during the festival and enjoy cultural programs and fairs. So my dear students, these are all about the festivals of Northeast India. The people of Northeast India are celebrating all these festivals with great enthusiasm and joy. Okay. I have given you all the festivals in a tabular form so that you can remember it easily. And the tabular form helps you to remember all the festivals easily and help you to secure good marks in objective type questions. Okay. Dear students, I hope you must understand about the people of Northeast India, about different type of states that are present in Northeast India or situated in Northeast India, and about the festivals that are celebrating by the people of Northeast India. Okay. That's all. Have a good day.